Welcome back to Let's Code. Today we're going to talk about this example, which we have already actually talked about on this channel. But today we're going to talk about a change that just got merged into the Bevy main branch, which will be coming in Bevy 0.9, relating to specifically time as a variable in shaders and how we access time and how we update it. So we're using time for the pulse wave that goes around the sphere right here. And before, we needed to add this in ourselves. So I'll bring this down a little bit, and then let's go look at the new bindings. So there's mesh view types and mesh view bindings. These are two files inside of the Bevy crates, specifically Bevy PBR, inside of source render, and then this one is mesh view types, and the other one is mesh view bindings. So right at the bottom of both of these files, you'll see on the left in the types file, we have this new struct called globals. Now this is a WGSL file, but the syntax looks a lot like what you would see in Rust. The new values that are added are time, delta time, and frame count. And you can read the descriptions here. So we get the time since startup as the time variable, the time since the previous frame in seconds in delta time, and then the frame count since the start of the app. Both the frame count and time actually will wrap. So if your program runs for an hour, time will wrap around. Well, frame count will wrap around when it reaches the max value for U32. So this is the type definition. And then we can see that it is being bound in group 0 at binding location number 9 as a uniform that is called globals. And this is honestly super exciting. You can see here that I've updated my dependencies in my cargo toml for this particular example to use the main branch, specifically this commit. I've also done a little bit of work to upgrade the Bevy shader utils crate that I use to 0.9, or at least the development version that will be 0.9. And then all we have to do is bring in the mesh view bindings, and then we have access to globals.time. And that's it. Everything else is just removing code. So this change was added in PR 5409 if you're interested. And if we go to the Bevy 0.9 dev branch inside of the Bevy examples repo that we put all these examples in, we can see the changes that have happened. And you can kind of see what I mean. So let's start with the material inside of main.rs. Previously, the material was a custom material that had the time set in it. And then we had this function called update time for custom material that would grab our custom materials, and we would grab the time resource. And for every material, we would set the time seconds and startup inside of that material. The usage of that inside of our shaders was very similar to the usage that we see now in the globals. So we've got our custom material here. In the 0.9 world, this is going to be called globals. And then we have time, which is getting updated by that system. In our case, we bound it to group 1 at binding 0 because we only had the one binding. And then we got to use it as material.time. Now you can still do this for any value that you want to do if you want to update or keep some value updated. But for a time, we no longer need to do this. We get to use globals.time because it's coming in from those Bevy mesh binding imports. The other thing that I'll mention since we're here is in 0.9, there is an update to spawn. So spawn bundle is now deprecated. So what we end up getting here is commands.spawn, and spawn takes a tuple, or it can take a tuple. So instead of doing spawn bundle insert, you can now spawn a single tuple with multiple components. Now, the dot insert pattern is not going away. That is not deprecated. Only the spawn bundle function is. So you can still spawn one component and then do dot insert, and that's still valid. In this case, I've chosen to change it. But that's it. Even for this fairly small example, we get to remove a bunch of code and not have to deal with maintaining these values ourselves or setting them up in any of the other shaders where we are going to need the time binding, which is, if you're familiar with the shader work that we've been doing, quite a lot of them. It's almost all of them, in fact. So that's really all I wanted to cover today. I wanted to point out that the time binding that we've been using in Bevy 0.8 with the new material APIs and the new shader support is now going to be even easier. So Bevy is making great strides in the usability of these shader APIs, which I just love. And it's wonderful. And it's a nice quality of life improvement that I'm super happy about. So thank you to everybody that worked on that PR. And for all of you watching the video, have a great day, and I'll see you in the next one.